Right, so this is Tips 47 for Rogue Galaxy. I'm in the Ghost Ship Extreme. I'm on level 29. I just wanted to do a quick rare beasts update. Black Buffalo. Because the beasts in this dungeon, it's there's 100 floors, and every 30 floors the beasts change, so it's about to get the first 30 floors squared away before you get onto the next one. You won't have much difficulty, actually. I had a bit of a panic when I first got in there. I thought, oh my god, there's all these rare looking beasts, but actually I've had no problem getting them at all. For the first 30 floors, you're looking at, we've got a Ghost Bafu, no problem getting that. Look, I've got 100. Shell Knight Zombie, thought I had a problem getting that, not a problem, and it's not a barrier. So you can kill all of these, Spritz, Soul Epitaph, and Skullwood. I thought, oh, well, that's going to be a rare one. But it wasn't. You can see I've only got 200 of them. So all of those ones I've just shown you occur on every single floor, 1 to 30, so you'll have no problem with that at all. When you get to like level 15, Black Buffalo start turning up. And then when you get to sort of level 22 or 21, 22, blue ogres start turning up. So, but as you can see, absolutely no problem. I've got another 11 of these blue ogres to get, but I'm just going to run around on floor 29 before I get to the boss, and I shouldn't have a problem getting them at all. They've been turning up in sort of twos, the blue ogres. They're probably the nearest. Oh look, there you go. They're actually purple. Bit of a moan, but ones and twos, they sort of turn up in, so I shouldn't be here too long, actually. The thing I've been doing with the floors, I have done videos for each floor, but when you do it, you're going to get a different layout because it's randomly generated, the floor design. I've been making sure I touch the save point on each floor just in case if we get to level 100, that it'll, you know, fill out the map for us, but I've got a feeling it won't do that. Also, I've got a feeling that some of the floors have two save points, so I've just sort of been hitting a save point on each floor and getting to the red lifts, because if you haven't played this before, the purple lifts are not lifts that you can use to go up a floor, the red ones are, so you're looking for the red lifts and the ignoring the purple ones. See, that's the one we'd be able to go up in. I think we'll do that now, actually, because I've hit the save point on this floor, so yeah, so that's what I'm gonna do. I might actually stick around and get some more ogres. Oh, there's a chest there. Nothing spectacular in the chest, actually. Yeah, same old rubbish, really. No weapons. Oh, I have managed actually to level up two really good weapons for Jester. So the Sword of Sin that I got from the first ghost ship is now Diablos, fully mastered. Check those stats out. But even better is the Dorgan Edge, which you get from beating the boss in the other ghost ship, the original ghost ship. And the this is the Dorgan Caliber now. Check those out, 500. And you do get a sword at the end of this one, I seem to remember as well, so hopefully that will be even better than this one. So that's that, really. Yeah, so I'm just gonna run around and get me blue ogres. I wouldn't be worried about black buffaloes, they turn up in five sometimes, so. And everything on floors 1 to 30 you can kill immediately with a special attack. So Lilica's, what's her one? She's got a really good one with Jupus. So combination attacks with other members of your team work well. Lilica's one with Jupus, I'm just trying to remember what it's called now, something like Advent of the Sun, that's right, yeah, so that's a good one. Segrim's Gates of Hell, Jaster's top, also all your top ones basically. So your Supernova, all that kind of stuff work really well. Actually, Digo's, look, I think it's covering something. I've used it about a billion times. Covering Fire, he's the only person that can actually murder everything in one go. So everything from floors 1 to 30 you can just kill with a special attack. So most of the bosses have been quite easy actually. It's sort of strategy I've been using is just stay away from them and using the sort of attack enhancer ability, and the illusion sword seems to be working quite well. It gets quite tricky later on, so I shan't be able to use that for much longer, but I mean the first 30 levels have been pretty easy actually. Quite easy to get blasé, really. But I do seem to remember levels 60 to 90 get really difficult, and then you get a bit of a break around level 90. Seems to get a little bit easier. I don't know, it's because I think they mix up the barriers and you end up sort of like killing one beast at a time sort of thing, because it's because of all the different barriers, all the like giants and stuff, so it can get a bit tricky. So save, try and save on every level if you can. Not many blue ogres here. They are sort of rarer than everything else, but I don't imagine that being much longer. There you go, look, two blue ogres. If you didn't know as well, before you use the keys to the underworld, just use the key that you get when you answer the 7 questions with Minhok. It'd be a good idea if you finish off the beasts. Oh, there's a shop there. There's a shop every 30 levels. So before you use the key to the underworld to get into the Ghost Ship Extreme, I would finish off your beasts in the original Ghost Ship Extreme, because you won't be able to get in there again. That disappears and the beasts disappear with it until you finish this massive dungeon. So I would do that before you go in there. See what he's got. I might actually sort of max out my healing stuff, because it gets a bit tricky later, and I can stash a lot of this in there. Save point till later. They're every 30 levels, and the beast change every 30 levels as well, so it's kind of easy to remember. Oh, some rubies, brilliant. I've only got 64 of those. So anyway, so I'm going to sort of hit this save point here, run around, get the last of my ogres, and then do the boss, and then go on to the next bit.